Hello YouTube and welcome to the third video tutorial about Timmy and Anatella. I am Frank Vandenbergen, CEO of Timmy. In the previous video, we installed Timmy and we created together our first Anatella graph. We imported a text file inside Anatella and we talked about the difference between connect mode and run mode. So let's go back to our first example, this one. To remind you, the objective was to plot a small bar chart there that illustrates the different education levels of the women inside the United States. To do so, our Anatella graph here is composed of five little boxes. We already have the first box, the text importation box. Let's now add the second box here. This second box selects all the rows that represent women, or in other words, it filters out all the rows inside the input table here that and only keeps the rows that are women. Let's now go back to Anatella. We'll restart from the graph that we created in the previous session. To open this graph, you go to your working directory and you double-click your Tuto Anatella file. Let's add inside our graph a new row filter box. This box is inside the transformation boxes inside the standard category. So I'll just drag and drop this little box just here. If you let your mouse hover above one icon, it displays the name of the icon. So you can see that here I have a row filter box, this is a calculator box, this is an aggregator box, a sort box, and so on and so on. You can always right-click a box also. So I'm right-clicking a box and I get help on the box. I'm right-clicking another box, like the calculator box here, and I get help on the calculator box. As you can see here, there are really plenty of boxes. But don't worry, 99% of the time, you only need to use the boxes that are inside the first three categories. The category Run, Join, and Standard. And these are really the only boxes that you should really care about. Let's open the property window of our new row filter box. You just double-click the box. You can now pause the video to add to your graph the row filter box and open its property window. Let's start with a very simple filter. One column of the information that we have inside our dataset is the age column. It's visible just here. So let's do a filter that keeps only the individuals younger than 50 years old. To do so, I'll just click here and write age lower than 50. Okay. Then I switch to run mode. Here I'm already in run mode and I click the output pin of the box. Oh, and it doesn't work. The box turns red and doesn't execute. How is that so? The age column here, it's defined, it's present inside our dataset, so it should work. When I have an error like that, the first reflex is to click the check button, just here. So Anatella tells me undefined token age. Then Anatella shows me the most probable cause of the error. It didn't work because before being able to use a column inside a mathematical expression here, I first need to declare this column inside the left panel just there. To do so, I click the little plus button, so I click this button just here. Then you have this column chooser window. It's a very common window in Anatella. It appears all the time. If you want all the details on how to operate this window, you can refer to section 514 of the help file. And to get the help file, you just press F1 inside Anatella. But for the time being, let's stick to the basic operation of this window. You just click refresh from pin, double click age, go to the bottom here, you press the OK button, and that's it. It should now work. So let's switch to run mode, click the output pin, and yes, it's working. You can now pause the video to configure and run yourself the raw filter box to see the people that are younger than 50 years old. Let's now do the filters that you are really interested in, the filters that only keep the rows that represent women. So now I put aside this little filter box and I'll take another one. Okay. I can double click the parameter of this new box to see them. Now just pay attention to this green border here. It means that it's this precise box that I am currently editing. It's the parameter of that box that I am seeing just here. So, inside my new raw filter box, I only want to keep the rows that represent women. So, I add here, using the plus sign, the column sex here, because I write an expression based on sex. And I write here, sex equals female. Sex equal female. Okay. So I move the cursor out of the text box and once again everything turns red to indicate an error inside our expression. So as usual, I click the check button. Anatella shows me the source of the error. It's a complicated message about no conversion to type S. S means string. It also shows me how to solve the error here. So it just wants me to uncheck the little checkbox there. Maybe you remember that a little bit earlier, I told you that there are only two important things to remember when working with Anatella. The first of these things was the difference between connect mode and run mode. The second thing to remember is actually this little box here. So pay attention, please, it's important. 99% of the time, when there is some error inside this raw filter or inside the calculator box, this is always because of this little checkbox here. So it should be unchecked. Now, a little bit more details about the error. What's really happening here? The error was about conversion to type S. S means strings. We have an expression here, and on the right side of this equal sign here, we have a string, some text. On the other side of the equal sign, we have the variable sex, and currently sex is still defined as a number, as you can see here. Now, to solve the error, I need to tell Anatella that the variable sex is also a string and not a number. To do that, I just uncheck the little checkbox here. And everything should work now. Everything is white. Or is it really working? Let's check. So, switch to execute mode, run mode, and let's execute the graph. We'll click on the output pin of the raw filter box. Let's click that here on the top and we get an empty table. That's unexpected. Let's have a look at the column sex to try to understand what's happening there. So let's go back at the previous step just here before. Okay. And go to the column sex. Let's try to find what might have caused this unexpected empty table. There is an error here inside of our expression, but which one is it? Let's look here and try to guess the error. You can pause the video and have a little bit thinking and go back when you have found the answer. So, as you might have guessed, the error is coming from this F character, just here. Inside the data, it's a capital F. And inside our expression, it's a small f. And since Anatella is skin sensitive, it gives you an empty output table, because apparently there is absolutely no row inside our data where female is written with a small F character. To avoid such errors, it's interesting to be able to rapidly look at reports describing the exact content of a column. To do so, you can right-click the header of a column. So I right-click the header of a column just here and select Create chart as nominal var. So as you can see, there is only two values inside this column, female and male, both with a capital letter. Now, there are several ways to fix the error. The first and easy way is just to write a capital F. So let's do that. Let's run again. And now we have some output. Now you can pause the video, fix the error, and rerun the row filter box. Just check that you have nearly 104,000 rows as output. Another way to fix the error is to use a more complex mathematical expression just here. For example, I could write something like this. To lower of sex. Okay. You don't need to learn by heart the name of all these functions. The list of all available functions here is given in the Help tab. For example, inside the string category, you will find the toLower function just there. So let's now execute the little box. And again, I get nearly 104,000 rows as output. Yes! There is another box that works exactly in the same way as the row filter box. It's a calculator box. Let me show you a quick example. So I'll take my calculator box. So, I just created here, with the calculator box, a new column named net gain. That is the difference between capital gain and capital loss. Before being able to use capital gain and capital loss, I must first declare these two columns on the left side. Congratulations on learning how to use the row filter box and the calculator box. These two boxes are actually the most difficult boxes to master in Anatella, so you made a decisive step here. You can now proceed to the next section of this tutorial. To do so, just click here. Bye.